Alright everyone, welcome back here to the Seems Good Magic channel for match number 3 with our sweet modern Masters deck. We're just going to try to make it happen here. Not sure if it's going to work or not, but we're going to try to make it happen. Ooh, I think it's actually better to Signature. Because then we can start the Mr. Ravening on the next turn. There's actually something I want to play Coiling Oracle against, not Mistraven. Interesting. No attack. Cathari Bomber. Alright, I'm just going to Mistraven, bouncing your Cathari Bomber, I guess. No reason to attack here when I have Ghostly Flickers. They know I have Ghostly Flickers, though, because they know I have one. They don't know I have two. Oh, jeez. Oh, my God. Olivia? How am I expected to deal with Olivia? Oh my lord. At least I can Aether Toe it. Come on. That has to succeed. The sick part is they get to kill my Mistraven or my Coiling Oracle, whichever one they want to kill. That's just the sick part. Ooh, okay. Now they get to play the Cathari Bomber, I imagine. Yeah. Alright, well, we're going to Cackling Counterpart Mistraven. Bouncing your Cathari Bomber. Attacking with Mistraven. this is about to get a lot of fun, by the way, when they play Cathari Bomber again, and then we copy the... Oh, Spike Jester. Alright, well, we're going to have to block one of those Spike Jesters. That's too many Spike Jesters. I can't deal with that many Spike Jesters. Seagate Oracle, interesting. Alright, I'll Oracle some Seagates. Ooh, I'm gonna take a Sensor Splicer here. Yeah, so I think I'm in the lead now. Okay, did not do that correctly, hold on. Going to do that, and then do this. So I'm gonna bounce both of these. Obviously they can just kill the Mistraven. But, so yeah, I think I did that wrong, actually. Alright, bouncing on Cathari Bomber again. Just no chance that's ever resolving. Ooh, putting Thragtusk in my hand for sure. It's the black-red deck. I would really like to put Thragtusk in my hand, although it is kind of a liability against the Sacrifice deck. It can... Ooh, two Cathari Bombers. What do I do here? I think I just bounce them again, to be completely honest. I think that's just my plan. I'm going to return this Cathari Bomber to your hand. I'm going to look at the top three of my cards. I'm going to take a Momentary Blink. Alright, I get to call the Conclave here. I can also Cackling Counterpart next turn if I want. I mean, this is just showing off what my deck can do. I mean, I'm basically just time walking them, going to at some point just cast a huge Sphinx's Revelation. I mean, okay. I don't mind just blocking with the Seagate Oracle. That doesn't really bother me. I'm just happy they don't have, like, Scorched Rusaka, Sacrifice My Mistraven. Ooh, Bone Splinters? Yeah, okay. Good for you, man. Good for you. Oh. Yeah, that's the best card in the deck, because it means that I can blink my Thragtusk. So they have another Cathari Bomber in the wait. They can also bring back their current Cathari Bomber from the graveyard. I'm just kind of going to let them make all the tokens they want, though. I think I'm going to be able to get enough life here with Sphinx's Revelation in a minute. And with Cackling Counterpart, Momentary Blink. I have a lot of options. I imagine this is them... Oh, okay. No. That kind of stuff does not fly in this house for sure. Okay, back up to 18 very quickly, from 8 to 18. I wonder if they have something to kill the Thragtusk. That could have been useful before, maybe. Alright, so I can Cackling Counterpart create a copy of Thragtusk at instant speed. Yeah, I mean, I'm just going to take that, obviously. Oh man, Mistraven? So, this is an instant, right? Yeah, so I can just make another Thragtusk instant speed, basically. Or I can Sphinx's Rev for 4 if I really want to. Olivia? Do they have two Olivias, or do they shuffle somehow? Or does Aether Toe not do what I think it does? Oh, on top of its owner's library. Okay, it does do what I think it does. Okay. Okay, I'm going to create a copy here. Okay, for some reason I thought Aether Toe was bottom, but that's okay. Wow, land is awesome here, actually. I get to Mistraven the Olivia away. I could also Mistraven the Goblin away, but let's be honest, the Olivia is way more important here. And then, I mean, I assume they're just taking 8, going to block the real Thragtusk. And that's fine with me, because Momentary Blink can only do one thing, and Ghostly Flicker's already gone, so I'm not too worried about it. Alright, I mean, if they play Olivia, I'm just going to Momentary Blink my Mistraven, killing their Olivia. Ooh, Thunder's Wrath. That's pretty good. If they kill this Mistraven, then that's kind of bad. Still not the worst. I don't think I'm just cycling Sphinx's Rev to draw one card. I don't think that's how I win the game here. I just don't think that's how I win the game here. Thunderous Wrath. Let's see. So if they Thunderous Wrath, my Mistraven, whatever, and then they 1, 2, 3, 4 cast Olivia, they have to block with Olivia next turn. And Olivia is a 3-3, so it has to either chump a Thrag, or trade with a Thragtusk or trade with a Beast. Unless they play another land. No, and then they still... Okay, there's no bad spot. Okay, awesome. Well, they show us Thunderous Wrath for some reason. They probably should have thought about that before they conceded. Alright, let's get it done. I don't love Spell Pierce. We don't have a lot of removal, by the way. Aether Toe is decent, but it's really only good against Olivia. Is this the matchup where Unflinching Courage is just absurd? Huh. Actually, maybe Talon Trooper is better. I mean, we have 3 Centaur Healers and a Thragtusk and a Sphinx's Rev. I don't know how much life we really need to gain. Also, I've not gone off with Mist Meadow Witch yet, maybe just because no one's let me. So the card hasn't super pressed me, but my opponent has also killed it every time. This hand does not seem insane, but it has the ability to be insane. I mean, if I just draw one of those, like, Simic whatevers, then I'm on point. Alright, I imagine I'm not playing Corehook Master, but I could. Ooh, Ghostly Flicker. That makes this hand really good. Alright, let's see what our opponent plays. Nothing? Alright, well, that's one way for us to get ahead. Just going to play a Seagate Oracle. Sphinx's Rev. I've not revved yet, so I really want to rev this game. The one game we were going to rev, we were stopped short. So I'm excited to be able to use the card if I can use the card. I don't think this means it's bad in limited. It's obviously great in the late game. Two hand via lances, very interesting. I know I probably got some hate for saying it like that, but I don't. I mean, it's probably just hand wire. But that's just not as exciting as like putting on a really bad fake German accent and trying to do it, you know. All right, so what's going down, I imagine, is attacking with Corehook Meister and Sensor Splicering. If they, if they don't Soul Bond. If they do Soul Bond, I'm obviously not attacking, just playing a Sensor Splicer and then flickering, probably like Oracle Splicer on the next turn, trying to draw a green land and then Center Healing. If I draw a green land here, by the way, the plan's the same. If I draw a Simic Guildgate, then I don't know what the plan is. I've not planned around drawing a Simic Guildgate. What's my plan if I draw a Simic Signet? The bar of soap. I don't know what the plan is there either. Alright. Kirby's Advocate 02. I'm waiting for you, sir. I assume you're not just going to concede again, but I don't really know. Alright. Making some moves. So no Soul Bond. Oh, Soul Bond, okay. It actually makes this decision interesting, but I don't think it's interesting enough. Like, I think I just play the 5-drop. Yeah, okay, definitely just playing the 5-drop there. Ooh. Ooh. A little attack with both. Alright, I go to 10. Bar of soap. That's what I needed. I'm just gonna attack with everything. And I'm going to, on my opponent's upkeep, I'm going to flicker Sensor Splicer Corehook Master. I don't need more things from Seagate Oracle. I just need to, Alright, I'm going to tap down the one on the left. That one looks more dangerous to me. I mean, I'm happy to block with two golems. And then if you just, like, have the removal spell, you waste your turn having the removal spell. That's fine, too. Traitor's Instinct. Okay. I mean, what if I do this? I don't even know how he responds to that. Okay, I mean, then I'm just gonna make another token next turn. Yeah, I'm happy to take 5 here. Again. Ooh, Ghostly Flicker plus Momentary Blink. Okay, so I get to play Centaur Healer for sure. And then I get to attack with everything. And then I get to Ghostly Flicker next. Yeah, I mean, I'm winning this game. So that triple block I thought was going to kill the Lancer. I obviously misjudged, but it's not going to matter too much, probably. Even if this is Olivia, I just get to, like, bounce, go to 11. Bounce, go to 11 and win, probably. Something like that. Yeah. Yeah, okay, I'm just taking five here. Huh. Even like Thunderous Wrath doesn't get me. I'm very confused. Don't think the villain here thought of the best plan in the world. So they can have Magma Jet, but they can't have much else. All right, I'm just gonna protect myself a little bit here. Ooh, Miss Meta Witch. That's an exciting one, but I do have Momentary Blink plus Centaur Healer, so I'm not too concerned. All right, so if I attack with all these, he has to block one, right? So I just attack with everything, might as well. Might as well. What are they gonna do against it? I have Momentary Blink plus Momentary Blink Flashback, or I can, yeah, okay. We did it. 100 new items, just 100 play points. All right, so we broke even there. Thank you everybody so much for watching. See you for the next one. There are a lot of these coming, so I hope you like them. Don't forget to like this video and let me know in the comments how your Modern Masters experience is going. So I'll see you for the next one.